Yes, sir, you can start.
Yeah, I've already introduced Devagni. So Devagni, the session is all yours now.
Okay.
Great. I'll start sharing my screen in that case.
Yeah.
Okay, so a brief introduction about myself, although Pawan sir has introduced me well. Myself, Devagni, from 2009-11 batch, and I've been working in different sector of the travel industry for quite some time now, starting with being in corporate sales in Snow Leopard Adventure, then moving on to Peak DMC for 3.5 years, and then joining in Tamarind Global after taking a break of one and a half years. So the today's topic that I would be handling is UGC NECT. And this is a examination which is go to examination for many students, and I cracked NET just last year, 2019 December, and now that many of you are in your final year, so most of you may be looking forward for attempting this examination as well, and wondering what is it all about. Should I be taking this examination? Should I be joining a job? What shall I do? So first, a brief about this examination. This examination is a national eligibility test, and there you have got 180 minutes, questions of 300 marks. The papers are two papers. One is paper one and paper two. Paper one is general paper, which is mainly judging your teaching aptitude and research as well. And hello. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am, you are.
Someone else is presenting, it seems. Yeah, I go again. is the screen visible now?
Yes, it is visible, Devagni.
Acha. So, yes, so the paper, so where was I? Okay, so the total marks in the paper is 300, and so basic eligibility for getting the certificate of the NET is you need to secure 55% of your marks if you are in general category. Reserved category, it's 50%. Now, once you get the certificate of NET, you need to qualify your master's degree within 2 years of getting the certificate. Now, there are two categories. Once you qualify the NET examination, you either qualify for assistant lectureship or junior research fellowship you are being awarded. Now, generally junior research fellowship, if you secure, matlab, there is a benchmark of a cutoff percentage as per the appearing and marks you secure. But there is a trend that has been prevailing. Minimum 60% if you get in the NET exam, then you qualify for JRF. And in paper one and paper two, there are in total 150 questions. All of them are 2 marks each, and there is no negative marking. Well, there is no gap. Like initially, there used to be a break of some time between two papers, but now they have changed it. The pattern has also changed since 2018. So any previous year question papers that you collect and solve them, they are you need to judge their quantify their relevance and then go forward for it. So whenever you do something in your life or jump into the next level, there are so many questions that pops up, like where, who, what. So even when you start think of preparing the NET examination or taking up this exam, so there are a few questions that is going to go ahead and you would be wondering. So I would be taking up few questions through my presentation, and I would try to help you guys through my personal experience. So anything that I give away through this presentation has worked out for me on personal level, doesn't mean it will work out for you, because it is a study thing and it has an individual individuality to it. So the first question, that is why, and this is again a personal opinion, before you start doing anything, I feel it is very important, and the foremost thing to do is to clear about the segment, that why you want to do this, why you want to take that job, why you want to start that business, why you want to take the examination. And initially it won't be a critical question to you, but at the end of the day, when you fail in doing something or achieving something what you had planned, it keeps you going. Like it keeps you, the why, remembering the why you started it all together, it keeps you going and maintains that consistency. So for me, why did I take a NET examination is okay. So there's a very personal story attached to it. When I had enrolled myself in IITTM, and it was the year 2009, that was the time of recession, and industry was going through a hard patch, and economy was tensed. So one day in one lecture, Pawan sir came up, and he was hosting this class. I don't remember clearly which one, but all of a sudden there was this discussion, and it came up that he asked us, have you noticed people increase their certifications when there's this time, there's this difficult crisis wala time, they start increasing their certificates. So a teacher is always at work, and this anecdote or this whatever you say, this kind of sentence clicked in my mind that okay, obviously you are never out of job. That is one thing that got attached to me, but there was something in it which made me attached to lots of whys that I've been thinking over the years, and I have been consistently working towards the goal. Yes, plans did not work for me for quite some time now, but still. So this was something which was my personal why. So you need to understand why you want to take this exam altogether. Moving on to next, once you have cleared your mind and you have started preparing, you need a plan to go about it. And first thing which is there is observing the syllabus. And when I say observing, it is actually observing. Like, you don't have to mug up the syllabus, or you don't have to be terrified, because when you see the syllabus, they have 10 units, and this is mostly true for every examination that you prepare. This is the universal thumb rule. Before preparing for any examination, you should start looking forward for the syllabus. And the next syllabus in particular, I found it very, very elaborate as to what to study, giving you exact direction where to pick it from. Because if you see tourism, like this is again a personal thing that I have faced. When you start preparing for NET, there are not many institutes, not many YouTube channels that have this coaching facility for tourism management. And that becomes really frustrating when you go online and you don't find a ready material. And although I think that tourism being a subject, it's amalgamation of many subjects, like history bhi padhna hai, geography bhi hai, socio-economic cheeze bhi hai involved. And it is actually, when you come to think of it, it is very difficult subject, because you don't know where to stop, where to draw a line while preparation. Another thing, then you read a syllabus, like I have a section of syllabus. Let's see, this is the unit one that we see. Now, if you take an example of this, if you see, like, let's suppose these organizations in the syllabus. Now, when you are reading through the syllabus, you are making a plan how to study. So let's see these organizations. So when you are applying for the examination, so NET, NTS already presumes that you already know the full form of it. So what is more to it? How shall you see the syllabus and prepare yourself? So let's say IITA. Now, IITA has chairman of Board of Governors. Now, who is the chairman of the IITA currently? You have to know that. Let's say, again, concentrating on your country, who are Board of Governors in IITA from your company, country? Like, if I'm not wrong, it's Ranojay Datta and it's Ajay Singh. So now from here, the trail begins. How are these eminent personalities connected to this organization? What they do? So Ranojay Datta is CEO of Indigo, and Ajay Singh is SpiceJet's MD. So you need to understand that. And where they help you is to NTA, where from the time they have changed their pattern, they stopped asking questions which are very direct. So they are not very difficult, but then they are not very direct. Like they have stopped asking full forms. They started asking where is the headquarters of SpiceJet, or where is the meet of IITO happened. Wow, who is the president of whose? So you need to go and dig deeper into it, because when it comes to MCQs, you have to go between the lines and start collect. Similarly, Archaeological Survey of India, they are not going to ask you hierarchies. They will ask you how many monuments are under Archaeological Survey of India, things like that. So it is not difficult, don't be terrified, but then it is not very easy also that they will be asking direct questions. Start taking notes. Now, how do you take notes? Because under the sun, there are so many topics to study, and there is no streamlining. You can't streamline that. So one, I'll give one one section I when I was preparing for NET and I was working as well as I was preparing, so I wasn't getting enough time. But how I used to take notes, I will share that. Maybe that helps you out. I started writing in blank papers. There would be वो A4 size printing material होता है वो A4 size papers में. I used to draw margins, मतलब right and left पे, and I used to take notes. Notes only for the lengthy topics like climate change, models, Lipio model या फिर कोई भी model, वो सारी चीजें. Short and crisp, and I used to add अगर कोई news I come across कि ये हुआ है या ये president change हुआ है या कुछ भी, मतलब right side would be my updation column. I used to revise you. I would suggest you also to revise the notes. And after 7 days, I used to update those notes. He, if it is, if something has happened or not. Now another copy I used to keep, or you can also maintain loose sheets about things which can be jotted down in columns. So I had studied the syllabus, and you can see if you go through the syllabus, there would be sections wherein you would find luxury trains, topics like books and authors, folk dances, folk art, classical dances. These are some few topics that you can chart it out, and it really helps. मतलब एक नजर मार लो, क्योंकि there are many questions match the following, and if the sentence has been spoken correctly or not. So these are there. Keep a schedule. Initially when I had started NET and preparation for NET, and I thought of preparing for NET, there was so many things that I had to handle that I was not able to give time to studies at all. And कई बार क्या होता है कि you are in middle of something and you finish that work and the focus does not मतलब आता ही नहीं है, but you are unable to study, keep that focus available. So I used to make a few arrangements, like just सुबह का time. I'm a morning person, so I keep studies all to my morning things. But you being students, you have whole day for study, so कोई problem ही नहीं है तुम लोगों का, तो you can easily fit in to that so manage your time wisely, because course wise you see I am not sure, because I had passed out almost 10 years back, and what is the syllabus currently working out for the MBA students. But back then in my time, it was not very much current affair related for me, except for the subject of few subjects. Except for them, there was not many things which were current affairs, so I had to update myself. Moving on to next. Okay, this one is this is start solving question papers. जहां से भी जो भी मिले, start solving the question papers. Don't worry about आएगा कि नहीं आएगा, will I be able to do it or not, time नहीं है, I don't know anything. Start solving question papers from day one. I kept this thumb rule for paper one, because paper two में ही इतना सब कुछ था मेरे लिए पढ़ने के लिए, because I could not get anything for paper one to study from. So I had taken up help of question papers. I had solved, क्योंकि paper one का जो syllabus है, that they haven't changed much, and that is a blessing in disguise. So यू कैन फाइंड क्वेश्चन पेपर्स ऑनलाइन जाके भी एंड यू कैन सी यूजीसी नेट का पुराना वाला जो साइट है दैट इज स्टिल ऑपरेशनल दे हैव गॉट क्वेश्चन पेपर्स आउट देयर सॉरी सो डाउनलोड फ्रॉम देयर स्टार्ट सॉल्विंग इट फ्रॉम डे वन नाउ when you start solving of course answer is a big miss so solve question papers if you are getting that is good if you are not getting even better why because her question ke char options hai and you should be curious enough so when you solve the whole question paper wonder why those three were not right where you went wrong so this also helps you in preparing yahan se bhi try taking notes from these as well if you are very much inclined try taking notes from these as well because it is it helps these are very quick fix matlab pura lengthy prose text padhna bhi nahi padta and you are out right there sorry so there is a proverb curiosity killed the cat so I don't think well in here and with regards to knowledge trust me nobody has ever been killed for curiosity be curious and curious as to what is happening why is happening find that logic it helps you to remember logic as in why matlab ye hua to kyun hua find that logic ask that make it an habit agar ye sahi answer hai to why were and go deep like why these four options were only chosen what is the correlation there has to be a correlation jab bhi question banta hai if you are being confused matlab agar aapko confuse kiya ja raha hai preparing yourself is good but there are times when you have to have some little help from surrounding seek help from your classmates from your teachers are best teachers matlab best guidance guru what I can say like it's been so many years and still if I am in doubt and I am always in doubt trust me I go to lama sir I ask him and he boosts up the spirits and he gives me those pep talks ki acha why you are not doing this ya fir kuch bhi whatever your doubt there's this cloud in your mind jo hai it teachers help you clear that a lot and their experience imparts a great number level of understanding understanding the life altogether and so next slide anyone who has never made a mistake has never tried anything new okay so I have seen this in my surrounding as well and this is this is a personal observation that people are prone to perfection they are attracted to it and when they are reaching that level they forget to try they are scared to try new things like any new thing which you take up obviously you will be failing now but if you are thinking that and you are not attempting it that is a foolishness because in that case you will never know even if your capabilities lied in pursuing that or not so always make mistakes try new things and go for it like if you are thinking ki acha net hoga ki nahi hoga and people already matlab if you see net qualify dete 27,000 ya kitne bhi log hain and qualify sirf 100 log hi karte honge shayad and if you are not able to if you if that thought particular thought restricts you from taking that exam then I would say you are committing a crime for letting you yourself believe that you can't do that so don't judge yourself based on that try new things make mistakes never give up that's what bring on that consistency and keep up the good work going so I am sending positive vibes to you for any doubts you can reach me at my email if you have any questions let me know if you have guys any questions
hello
hello
Yeah, Devagni, could you just elaborate on the amount of time they need to spend on preparing for NET?
See, it has to be strategically maintained. So, being a professional, I had given every day 4 hours. And okay. I think if you are preparing a little, matlab, jaise 6 months ya 8 months pehle se, 4 to 5 years diligent wala. Is good enough to be thorough but there has to be a balance between the book and the current affair because after changing NTA's pattern they are very much specifying and emphasizing on the current affair kind of thing general knowledge wala What is the difference between difference? Okay, there's a question. Okay, Nidhi, what is the difference when we clear NET and when we clear JRF as well? Okay, so you clear NET, either you get a teacher a lectureship, assistant lectureship, and or you are qualified for JRF. Now JRF is junior research fellowship once you get that there are institutes like they need research fellowship so PhD ke liye this this really helps you get stipend and they after the required matlab basic attribute that they are looking forward for they take you up for research fellowship now agar aapko phd apply karna hai वैसे ही आप कर सकते हो
mba की डिग्री दिखा दो phd नहीं करेंगे
mba की डिग्री दिखा दो i could not hear you
mba की डिग्री दिला दो हम phd नहीं करनी हमें
who is this hello Yeah, you please continue. The Bagni, continue.
Okay, but then when you want to do PhD from like, if you are planning to do from IIM, if you want to apply, then they need JRF qualifications. So you have to have that. मतलब वो JRF से you get stipend and while you are in on PhD and sir can add on more if sir has any input. डिफरेंस क्या होता है
या जेआरएफ इज बेसिकली जूनियर रिसर्च फेलोशिप द टॉप रैंकर्स ऑफ नेट आर एंटाइटल्ड फॉर जेआरएफ जेआरएफ इज बेसिकली दैट यू आर बीइंग स्पॉन्सर्ड टू परस्यू योर पीएचडी फ्रॉम एनी ऑफ द यूनिवर्सिटीज एंड इंस्टीट्यूशंस इन इंडिया सो फर्स्ट ईयर आई थिंक द स्टाइपेंड इज 30,000 पर मंथ
सर 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 गुड क्वेश्चन सर सर पैसा कितना मिलेगा सर
हु इज दिस इडियट एक्चुअली आर यू वर्किंग हियर फॉर Paisa, then you are not fit for academics actually. Okay, now let me just complete. So first year you get 30,000 rupees per month plus I think 1.5 lakh as annual grant to attend seminars, conferences, contingency grant is there to buy books and all that stuff. And once you become SRF, that is senior research fellow, then you start getting 40,000 rupees per month. And earlier it used to be transferred to the university from where you are enrolled, or the institution from where you are enrolled for PhD. Then you used to get through the institution, but now the money is directly transferred to the candidate's account. So there is no hiccups. Earlier universities used to take a lot of time to give you the grant, but now it is directly transferred to your account. So the JRF is the cream de la cream of the net qualified people, right? So there are two agencies. Basically, the one agency which conducts all these examinations is now NTA, that is National Testing Agency. And all the science subjects are conducted by NTA through the CSIR, that is Council for Scientific and Industrial Research. So all science papers are conducted by them. And UGC conducts for the non-science papers, but the examination for both is done only by the National Testing Agency. As far as PhDs are concerned, now almost 70 odd universities offer you PhDs in tourism. Yeah, Bhumi, you have a question?
No, sir, I think there's a technical problem in my system. I'll just mute it.
Debagni, I have a question.
Sir, I would okay. like to ask a question, and this will be from the speaker.
Okay.
Go ahead. I'm actually I'm preparing for NET. Hopefully it will happen in July this time.
So they have not clarified that yet.
Right, yeah, they have postponed it for now. No dates are out yet. So as in you're, this was the first attempt for you, the December 2019.
This was my second attempt, but I had qualified both in both attempts, but then not JRF. I did not qualify for JRF.
Okay. And ma'am, my main concern is paper 2. As you mentioned, the syllabus is very vast. I have searched a lot, and as you said again, there is no help available, as in no coaching centers or anything. So I was really looking forward for your this session. Thank you for that.
Hello.
Thank you, Bhumi. There is one book that you can go for, which I had taken up for my first wala preparation. That is Truman's Tourism Management, which was very good and served a great purpose during my previous wala structure jo tha net ka. They give you word by word syllabus ka, and that really helps you. Barring that, start solving question papers, kyunki second attempt mein mujhe solving question paper helped a lot. क्योंकि जब आप क्वेश्चन पेपर सॉल्व करते हो, देर आर अगेन फोर ऑप्शंस रहते हैं, एंड स्टार्ट सर्चिंग आउट कि पहले ऑप्शन का व्हाट इज हू हू, सेकंड ऑप्शन का क्या है, मे बी अ क्वेश्चन आई डोंट हैव रेडीली अवेलेबल, इफ आई कुड गेट वन सो आई कुड एक्सप्लेन यू हाउ टू डू दैट. बट या ट्रूमेंस वाला जो टूरिज्म मैनेजमेंट का बुक है, दैट रियली हेल्प्स, यू कैन गो फॉर इट.
Thank you, ma'am.
Just to add upon to what Devagni said, the entire question papers are available in a book form. You please note down the name. Book is published by Professor Sheba Hamid. Right? Professor Sheba Hamid. She has published all the UGC NET papers of tourism administration for past so many years. And they come with the They are solved as well. So anybody intends to prepare for UGC NET and wants to solve the previous papers can get Sheba Hamid's book. That's available on Amazon also.
And it's in the I have seen the book in your library as well, and it is really good. Last year only they have published it. I'm so sorry, I forgot this to include this in the list. It's available in your IITTM ka library as well.
And anybody who wants to prepare for NET examination is having scarce resources. So I think our library is probably the most rich library in the entire country, with all domestic as well as foreign author books available. So if anybody is really keen, you are most welcome. Have a library iCard made. Come and sit in the library, read for the entire day. Nobody stops you.
So even for the ex-students?
Pardon?
For the ex-students.
Yes. Why not? We do have a library, norm, wherein anybody from anywhere in the entire India can come, and I think there is a caution money of 5,000 or something which is refundable. You get an iCard made, library card made, and you are free to come and access the library. Before the lockdown, you won't believe there are around 7-8 students from Kashmir Valley who have come down to prepare for NET examinations in Delhi, and one of my known person from Kashmir University, he gave my reference. So I've allowed them. वो आते हैं, अपना पढ़ाई करते हैं, अपना books लेके जाते हैं, उसका photocopy कराते हैं. Everything is open to everyone. The libraries are for you all only.
Okay.
So approach us, come to the institution, get the library card done, and you are there in the library. And one more thing, somebody has started preparing short series on topics related to the tourism administration paper. So if anybody is interested, and I have been emailed by that fellow, I do not know who's he, and I found them pretty tricky and easy to understand. So if anybody is interested, firstly send me your email IDs. I will forward those emails to all of you.
Okay, so next question is, please clear the passing marks for general category. There is no passing marks. There is cutoffs that they have. And generally, it is 50 and above. Matlab, if while you are practicing question papers, make sure to achieve at least 60%. By that ways, your security, you will qualify. Shall I complete only NET but not GRF? Shall I go to teach in government? You will be considered for job vacancies, but then I don't know. Pavan sir would be better help when clarifying this. I have heard ki PhDs would be taken into consideration for next year. Like, you need to at least enroll for PhD for next year. Is that true, sir, for next year?
That was just one of the suggestions, but I would still say that wherever you have, what is NET? NET is National Eligibility Test for Assistant Professorship, right? So you become eligible to get a assistant professor's job in any of the institutions, whether they are private or governments. But in GRF, you are given time to pursue your PhD, and you are paid stipend by the government as well.
Okay.
But the number of people who have qualified NET or PhDs, I would still say that NET becomes a desirable factor for, it's not compulsory yet, it is desirable. Even today, NET is not compulsory, but NET is desirable. But it is taken as a standard examination for your eligibility. So each and every institution goes in for. Even if we hire teaching associates in IITTM, first thing that we see that, okay, the person is qualified NET. Because let me just quote an example. In 2011-12, we had around 19 vacancies of assistant professors in IITTM, entry levels. So for those 19 vacancies, we had general SC, ST, OBC in all the quotas. We received around 525 applications. Now for 19 posts, 525 applications, how do you choose? Right. So the first criteria of eliminating people were First thing that we chose was people with JRF. Second thing, people with PhD. Then thing, third thing, people with NET. So NET virtually became desirable. It became mandatory, I would say, not desirable. It became mandatory. So if you're thinking of getting into academics, then NET is compulsory, I would say.
Ravi Sharma is asking, Pawan sir, I already buy this book. It should be, I already bought this book. I have seen there are few mistakes. Okay, great. You have found out. Sanjay Jamwal. Okay, yes. Sanjay Jamwal sir has initiated. But I guess there are only two or three lessons that have they have started. So not very regular. And there is also...
Yeah, not very regular, but they are coming up with the series every 10 days or 15 days. So as and when they are coming up with me, I can share it with you all. Plus, you do have some YouTube sessions available on NET, on YouTube, on the internet for your NET examinations.
Okay.
And most importantly, I would say, if you are really keen, come down to our library. I invite everybody to come down to the library, enroll yourself and get going.
Okay.
In fact, the libraries in all our centers are pretty rich for your NET preparation. But the problem is everybody wants all the things clubbed into just one handbook so that they can mug up the handbook and become a teacher. That is not going to happen. I would never suggest solve career prani questions ko, that is fine. Abhi aapko Amazon pe aur bookstores pe tourism administration ki guidebook bhi mil jayegi net ki JRF ki. But I'm not very sure about the authenticity of these guidebooks, but still you buy it. But trying to become a teacher and concising yourself only to one book would not be justifiable, I would say that. Har subject ki itni alag kitab hai, har subject ki kitab padhiye, tourism administration subject mein sab kuch aata hai, management bhi aata hai, tourism bhi hai, history bhi hai, Indian society and culture bhi hai, geography bhi hai. So separate books lijiye, apna notes banaiye and study from that.
Abhilasha, you had a doubt.
And for first paper, you have so many books available, so many guidebooks for the first paper, because it's common for every subject.
Yes, and question papers, I've seen this, question papers also help you. Matlab, question paper ke through, agar you start preparing, solving them, it gives you a lot of knowledge altogether. Matlab, agar kisi ko quickly, agar kisi ke paas ek mahine ka time hai.
I would still say... Devagni, people like us actually who set up the UGC question papers, right? कोई मार्क पेपर सेट करने नहीं आता है. हम ही सब लोग होते हैं जो पेपर सेट करते हैं. UGC का पैटर्न ये होता है कि there is a group of 7 to 8 teachers and we make a bank for them, question bank, right? And the UGC randomly selects questions out of the question bank prepared on different topics by different teachers. Every 6 months they do that. They prepare at least 3 sets of it. One set is given to you and 2 sets they keep themselves for any untoward happening. So as a teacher, where will I produce the questions? Right?
True.
I will also see the past questions. I will also see the guidebooks. I will also see the question papers or the questions given in the various prescribed syllabus books only. So these are my question banks as well to set up a question paper. So if you start reading these books, obviously I'll be producing questions from those books only.
Obviously. Huh. And books say always you get more enlightened than some shortcut. Matlab, obviously you have that edge of solving the questions as well. Okay. Ma'am, general category percentage. The general category percentage qualification is 55%. If you are getting 55%, then you are eligible to appear for NET. Abhilasha, you had a question.
Yeah, hi Debagni. I have two questions. First might sound a bit silly, but I just want to clear my doubt. Once I have qualified for NET, then is there any time limitation for applying further, or my NET is like that'll be I have qualified for life, like I can, if I decide to, like जस्ट ऐसे शौक के लिए अगर मैंने नेट अगर दे दिया जस्ट सेइंग एंड देन इफ आई डिसाइड लाइक 5 or 6 ईयर डाउन द लाइन कि नहीं आई शुड नाउ यूटिलाइज माय नेट क्वालिफिकेशन सो कैन दैट बी डन और लाइक आई विल हैव टू रीअपीयर फॉर अ टेस्ट और समथिंग और इज देयर एनी काइंड ऑफ टाइमलाइंस टू इट
डिपेंड्स व्हाट यू हैव क्वालिफाइड अगर जेआरएफ क्वालिफाई किया है तो 3 साल या 2 साल के अंदर यू हैव टू एनरोल योरसेल्फ फॉर पीएचडी एंड यू हैव टू that is only valid for a time limit but if you have qualified for lectureship that is for lifelong but within 2 years you have to qualify master's degree aapki complete
ra reda isanga mana cut ayindi
okay somebody else's microphone phone is on so
just switch off your microphone please gopal switch off your microphone
Okay.
Yeah, please continue.
Yeah, Debagni, my next question was like for this preparation of NET, how much is the esteemed daily newspapers like the Hindu or these kind of competitive magazines which come like for competitive examination purpose? How much are they helpful? I mean, will they how much will they help the students if they are preparing for NET examination?
Okay. Personally, when I started finding out these magazines and all, specifically for tourism, I could not get any. And I think Pawan sir would give better insight on to it.
Any magazine is available. Any
Yes, newspaper does help, but only when you know where to connect the dots. Like, कोई company का सीईओ चेंज हुआ या फिर जैसे कोई कंपनी बोर्ड ऑफ गवर्नर से हट गई सो यू हैव टू बी न्यूज़पेपर्स डू हेल्प इन दैट दैट इज व्हाट सर इज देयर एनी जर्नल मतलब ट्रैवल रिलेटेड व्हिच हेल्प्स यू
फॉर यूजी देयर आर 1000s ऑफ जर्नल्स फॉर प्रिपरेशन
बट हाउ हेल्पफुल आर दोस आई मीन
I would say if you keep on reading like Trap Talk, 333, 333 and all these magazines, at least you are abreast of what is latest happening in the tourism industry. And to be very frank, we also refer these magazines for preparing questions for current affairs related to tourism. But for say related to tourism resources of India, you have plenty of books on tourism products. You can read about various magazines and journals. जर्नल्स की पढ़ाई बहुत ज्यादा हेल्पफुल आपको नेट के एग्जाम में इसलिए नहीं होती है क्योंकि जर्नल एक पर्टिकुलर स्पेसिफिक टॉपिक पे लिखकर रिसर्च वर्क होती है राइट फ्रॉम वेयर वी मे नॉट बी एबल टू जनरेट अ क्वेश्चन एज सच सो बेसिकली द बुक्स एंड द मैगजीन्स एंड थिंग्स रिलेटेड टू टूरिज्म एंड अदर एस्पेक्ट्स व्हिच आर पार्ट ऑफ योर सिलेबस आर मोर हेल्पफुल देन गोइंग इन फॉर टूरिज्म रिलेटेड जर्नल्स There are at least 1,000 tourism journals published all across the globe. But journal studies are helpful once you become a teacher and you have to, develop a mastery on a subject or if you take a lecture on a particular subject, you start studying. Plus, once you become a teacher, you have to gain certain points, which are known as Academic Performance Index, API points, for further growth, right? Then journal studies becomes very important to learn how to write a good research paper, or how to do a research work, how to produce documents which are able to be published in international journals. For those purposes, journal studies are good. But otherwise, for NET preparation, I don't find too much of benefit of reading the journals. Journal आपके लिए life में academics में हमेशा काम आएंगे, but not for NET preparation. आगे के लिए हमेशा काम आएंगे आपके. There is no doubt you have to read good journals. You have to publish yourself in good journals so that you gain knowledge. You gain international, accolades and all those things. Plus, you have to get various points as well in the academic field to rise higher. So that journal is very very helpful.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Debagni.
There are so many travel magazines and travel books. I would say, Trap Talk. I have named you. Condé Nast is there, Travel Leisure is there, right? So many books are there, but they help you in getting what is the latest in the market. And of course, they also help you in enhancing your knowledge about the tourism resources. And you see, there are a lot of questions from tourism resources.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, anyone else has a question? Saurabh Banand Upasak, kya hai?
He has asked you for mentioning few PhD and special importance of MPhil in tourism. Please tell us some good universities for PhD and special importance of MPhil in tourism.
So I won't specifically name any university because we all are closely associated. But yes, central universities do have an edge. They have a better reputation as far as it is concerned कि आपने PhD कहाँ से की, तो मैंने XYZ Central University से की है. इसकी एक value होती है, IITM की एक value होती है. We have just entered into a tie-up with Indira Gandhi National Tribal University, जहाँ से हम MBO, BBA की degree दे रहे हैं. उनके through हम PhD की degree भी दे रहे हैं. And you will be surprised कि हमारे we have taken 14 students in the year 2018. Since then, we have not taken any students for PhD. And we had 500 plus applications for that. So PhD अब वो खेल नहीं रह गया जैसे पहले था कि हाँ आराम से करेंगे और सुपरवाइजर के मक्खन पॉलिश करेंगे और PhD हो जाएगी. अभी PhDs are a bit difficult now. You have to devote a lot of time in doing it. You have to complete a coursework. पहले तो आप एंट्रेंस टेस्ट क्वालिफाई करेंगे, एंट्रेंस टेस्ट क्वालिफाई करने के बाद आपका एनरोलमेंट होगा, फिर आपको कोर्स वर्क कंपलसरी 6 महीने का होता है वो करना होता है, उसके बाद एग्जाम होता है, आप उसको पास करेंगे तब आपकी कहीं गाइड अलॉटमेंट या सिनॉप्सिस का टाइम आता है. सो आई बिलीव एटलीस्ट डजन सेंट्रल यूनिवर्सिटीज इन इंडिया आर ऑफरिंग PhD प्रोग्राम्स इन एवरी नुक एंड कॉर्नर ऑफ द कंट्री. एंड I mean, you just go through Google PhD in tourism management in India, you will get the list of so many universities. Overall, I would say at least there are 70 universities in India now who are offering, including IITM, who are offering PhD programs in tourism administration and management. MPhil, I would say MPhil has lost its sheen in the real world nowadays. It's very rare people go in for MPhil, or majority of the universities don't even offer MPhil in tourism. So, agar aap NET qualified hai aur PhD kar rahe hai, to MPhil ki aapko zarurat nahi hai. Pehle MPhil liya jata tha NET ke jagah pe, ki acha theek hai aapne MPhil kar liya to you don't require NET, but now that is not the case. NET has become almost mandatory now. Sachi Grover is asking you, Dibagni, if you have any WhatsApp number, if she has some doubts to ask for in future, can you share your number or your mobile email ID?
Okay, email ID I've shared. I'll just share the number.
Yeah, it's already there. 11 minutes ago, Dibagni already shared the mobile number as well.
Okay.
Then, sir, kindly mention colleges, universities for PhD in Delhi. Apart from IITM Noida, there are PhDs in Jamia Millia Islamia. Then you have not a full-fledged tourism department, but there is a Center of Innovation cluster in Delhi University. You can also do PhD in tourism from an allied area as well. Like if your topic is related to a commercial aspect of tourism, you can enroll yourself in commerce department or management department as well. Then there is Bhimrao Ambedkar University, which is Delhi Administration University. It's not a central university. They also offer PhD in tourism and hospitality. And nearby, there is Gautam Buddha University. There is Ali Muslim University, then there is Rohtak University in Haryana, and I believe Mahindergarh Central University of Haryana is also coming up with tourism related PhDs. When is the NET 2020 will be held, sir? I am not aware of it.
They have postponed it. They are into discussions. There are suggestions कि अगर situation ठीक ठाक हो गई तो 15 जून के बाद जैसे dates था वैसा ही. Otherwise they will postpone it to July, but when they haven't mentioned.
Okay. what my experience is saying that there is not a single exam in the entire country which is declared for the month of June. So I'm 100% hopeful that any competitive exam will not be held before the month of July. For one simple reason, एग्जाम्स के लिए जो भी इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर चाहिए वो शायद जून तक आपको अवेलेबल नहीं हो पाएगा. लोग कहाँ फंसे होंगे, इंटरनेट अवेलेबल होगा नहीं होगा ऑनलाइन एग्जाम देने के लिए, एंड सो मेनी इश्यूज. और फिर जो सेंटर्स बनाएंगे वहां तक आपको जाने के लिए ट्रांसपोर्टेशन भी तो चाहिए. सो ड्यूरिंग द एयर ऑफ लॉकडाउन वी आर नॉट श्योर ट्रांसपोर्ट सिस्टम वाइब्रेंट कब होगा. सो आई डोंट फोरसी एनी एग्जाम बीइंग हेल्ड बिफोर जुलाई.
In future, can IITTM start preparatory classes for NET? That is a suggestion from Bhumi, like question from Bhumi sir to you.
Yeah.
That in future, can IITTM start preparing preparatory classes for NET?
I think anything can happen. Just to brief you, Bhumi, our mandate was to produce good quality trained manpower for the industry. So in 1996, we started with a one-year PG diploma program in Gwalior and Bhubaneswar. And then we joined in 2007 from various university backgrounds and all. So we started with PGDM, which was an AICT approved two-year program. Now PGDM में हमको बहुत सारी freedom होती थी syllabus की, exams की, और हम almost हर semester में syllabus change करते थे, keeping in mind the requirements of the industry. So the mandate of IITTM basically was to produce good quality manpower for the industry, not for the academics. But lot of schools demanded ki hum PGDM ke chalte hum aage net qualify nahi kar sakte hain, agar hum academics mein jana to hum nahi ja sakte hain. So that is precisely the reason we went into an MBA degree in collaboration with IGNTU. That was the only reason we went in for a master's degree. Otherwise, we were very, very happy with PGDM. हमारे जो syllabus था, जो आपने पढ़ाया उससे 100 गुना better syllabus हम लोग का PGDM में हुआ करता था international level. But now since we are affiliated to the university collaboration में है, तो हमें उनका syllabus follow करना पड़ता है. But still our open electives and जो specializations है वो हमारे हैं, जो कि university नहीं देती, हम देते हैं उनसे special permission लेके. But I would still not rule out that we can have preparatory classes. I'm not sure. जो पहला बैच था जो MBA का था 2015-17, उस बैच में से शायद किसी ने भी नेट का एग्जाम नहीं दिया, जबकि सबका बहुत हल्ला था कि हमें नेट करना है और एकेडमिक्स में जाना है. I don't remember even a single person from that batch going into academics. But yes, nothing can be ruled out. If there are more number of students, we can think of it. Yeah, Ravish has a question. If it is possible for you to make a WhatsApp group and add those candidates who are preparing for the UGC NET. Yes, it is very much possible. You all need to send your consent, your name and phone numbers. Ki I am interested in NET WhatsApp group. We'll form a group. हमें पहले ये तो मालूम हो कि कौन कौन नेट के लिए कोशिश कर रहे हैं, ये जानना भी तो जरूरी है.
Like there are 85 remaining participants right now attending. Now out of 85, how many of you are actually serious for the NET? I need to know that. जब तक हमको ये मालूम नहीं चलेगा, हम आपका WhatsApp group नहीं बना सकते.
True.
आप हमें बताइए कि आप WhatsApp group में enter होना चाहते हैं, आप NET के लिए serious हैं, हम आपके लिए WhatsApp group बना देंगे. अपनी तरफ से बहुत सारा material भी उसमें डालेंगे. आप मुझे मेरे personal number पे अपना email ID भेज दीजिए. जो जो मटेरियल अभी है यूजीसी नेट के लिए मेरे पास आ रहा है, आई विल सेंड इट अक्रॉस टू एवरीवन. ठीक है, एनी अदर क्वेश्चन? राइट
सर,
एनी क्लोजिंग रिमार्क्स दिबागनी?
यू कैन ऑलवेज रीच मी आउट इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट थ्रू. आई हैव ऑलरेडी शेयर्ड माय फोन नंबर एंड ये. Anybody can reach me out if they have any doubts or any portion they want to get an explanation from or clearing doubts. I've already shared my number and email. Sir, आप जब वो UGC वाला अगर बनाते हो WhatsApp group,
So I want myself to be included as well.
There's some problem